Thoughts with Duncan.
Does Do Not Touch exist in Braille?
Deep Thoughts with Duncan. Deep Thoughts with Duncan.
Duncan, where'd your shoes go?
Don't ask stupid questions.
Deep Thoughts with Xavier.
Give a man a foot, and he'll walk for a day. Teach a man a foot, and he'll walk for a lifetime.
Hey! Hey, you're stealing my bit!
No!
Deep Thoughts with Xavier.
Sometimes you just gotta take what you're given.
Do it!
Deep Thoughts with Duncan!
Patriotism.
Justice. Giving. Allegra.
Allegra. Allegra. Allegra. Allegra. Allegra. Allegra. Allegra. Allegra.
Hooray for Hollywood indeed. A land of glitz, glamour, a golden place where people go to make their dreams come true.
But this dream factory doesn't always churn out the goods. As some unfortunate souls find out, sometimes that golden dream turns into a nightmare.
Gentlemen, there is no need to fear. You know I love your movie studio. You have produced some of my favorite, how you say, mobile photographs. What was that silly little one? The comedy? Oh yes, Silence of the Lambs. Oh, I love that one. When he eats the guy's face, hilarious. I do not understand how you do it. But know what I don't love? I don't love when two people owe me 50 million rubles and cannot pay it.
Now, Mr. Moscow Lazarevich, Trans-Siberian Ruble Kremlin, if you'd just listen for a moment, I...
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
Oh! No, Mr. VBDB, I'm afraid the time for excuses has passed. Reddit, run from it. Destiny arrives all the same, and now it's here. Or should I say? I am.
Oh, jeez, Mr. Ruble Kremlin. Just give us more time. We'll... in 3 more weeks and we'll have an idea that'll sell like hotcakes.
Okay, you have 3 weeks. Although you may want to prepare for some cancellations because there may be some inclement weather conditions the weekend before the second week that will make it tough for you to film on Monday or Tuesday. And then after that, you may need to find a location to relocate to for Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday because, as you know, the power will be off at your studio and it will take some time to get those things back up. Although, it may be back up by that Friday, but at that point, you may just want to celebrate and go off with some live and pre-recorded music on both digital and vinyl formats. And maybe some dancing as well?
But then by that third Friday, I need the money.
Mr. Kremlin, that's all fine. But what time do we meet up on Friday?
I want the money by midnight. We'll meet at the American restaurant nearby, the one with the cheap oily beef sandwiches.
But Mr. Ruble Kremlin, didn't you hear? The beloved Dariette had a kitchen fire just a few weeks ago, and they'll be closed for 3 weeks. The very same 3 weeks that we're set to fill.
Oh, fine. We will meet at the chain restaurant owned by the Irishman.
McDonald's it is. We won't disappoint you.
And remember, 3 weeks.
Oh man, Paul. We need to come up with an idea for a movie, and fast!
But we don't write Neil Patrick Harris. That's what those weird creative types do. We just make all the money.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. What word did you just use there, Paul?
What, money? I love that word.
No, you called creative people weird, and you didn't do it in a loving and supporting way.
And why should I care about how people feel regarding my choice of diction?
Well, being open-minded and politically correct in my choice of language has given me the skills that I need to become a successful movie executive.
But you're not a success. You're a huge failure. Our studio has no money left. You're on the verge of losing your house, your job, your family, and you keep having identity crises left and right!
Just because something's true doesn't mean it's okay to say it. Sometimes I look in the mirror.
I don't even recognize myself.
Look, Neil, I'm sorry. What I said was real harsh. I apologize.
I'll always accept a genuine apology when it's offered to me. That's the Neil Patrick Harris promise.
You're a real weird guy, Neil. But man, I'm glad to have you on my team. I got a bench press at stake.
Which other?
No. Plus, you make a pretty good meat shield against the Russians.
Anything for you, Pauline.
I told you never to call me that. Don't touch me.
Okay, so recently I was studying abroad in Poland, thanks to the greatest college in the South, Southwest University. And right next to Poland, there's a country called France. And in France, they got a lot of good movies. So I'm thinking, we just do what they do over there, over here.
Jambon bon vas jambon. Petit baguette croissant.
Rouettel, le croissant c'est fin fort, vas-en c'est fin, c'est fin, encore c'est fort.
Remets les couets.
Ouais, pour de le soir.
A besoin de un.
J'ai voulu de croissant.
Coca bien.
Qu'est-ce de chien de la vie?
Y'a toi ma grenouille.
Beef bourguignon, soufflé, saviché.
Confit de quinard.
Au revoir.
What? Mia.
Non.
Non.
Ah oui. C'est un homme fou!
Le vroom vroom! Vroom 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 vroom! Le bang bang bang! Bang! Screw screw!
Un fal intrigué!
Le vroom vroom! Gratata! Gratata! Vroom vroom! Screw screw!
Kiki pa la fiena en fonction!
Le vroom vroom! Vroom vroom vroom! Vroom 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 vroom!
Yes, be not fini!
Je ne peux, plus qu'une day! Je ne peux!
Croissant!
Ah oui!
Croissant!
Ah oui!
Croissant!
Ah oui!
Baguette!
Oh non, les parabaguettes!
Elle n'était pas un problème.
C'est une vieille stupide, Pepe le Piu-Piu.
Je déteste ma vie.
No. Just no.
Hello, and thank you for your time today. We have a wonderful production ready for you with great actors.
No, I have to tell you, it's basically Gotham City in my 600-pound life.
It's what you want, it's what the people want, it's what we have.
think it's an interesting concept, but I think the burger thievery market's really oversaturated right now, and I don't know if we have the funds to make this movie stand out, you know?
You got a point, Neil. I mean, there's been a lot of burger-related heist movies in the last year. You've got Burger Boys, The Burger, Burgers 8, Burgers 11, People in the Burger, Steamed Hams, the musical. I hear they're doing a theatrical
release. Oh, I love that one.
Burger Time in Chinatown, Big Burger, the Great Burger Heist of 1911, Burger.
Yeah, so like mahalo, man. We need like a new type of horror film, and it's like really spooky, and it like really like kind of freaked me out, man. But it's a statement of racism in America, and once you see it, you're like, it's deep, man.
It'll really knock your stockings off, bro.
Yeah.
Breaking news. After 1 million years of hiding, Danny DeVito has emerged and is ready for revenge. Stay inside and try not to listen to.
You have to never take your headphones off and stay quiet, or else he'll get us.
We have to keep moving!
He's coming closer!
I have to go.
Stay safe.
I like the pitch, but the kind of trademark Hollywood, teenage, angsty style and attitude that you have, it's not very indicative of this time period. In fact, I'm not really quite sure where they're getting that from.
I don't know, Neil. I just can't take the man wearing a blanket seriously.
Hello, everybody. Now, you may be wondering why we would decide to create a band if our music tastes are so drastically different. Well, as you can see, we have come up with a plan. We have combined the best genres of music in our own humble opinion, pop, synth, grunge, and emo, and combined them into one phenomenal music genre that will surely create a cornerstone in the music industry.
I'll have you know they have amazing fan base in Russia.
Shall we roll the trailer?
The band that started it all and gave rise to an entirely new genre of music. Three best friends. Whose journey started with an idea.
So, what was your first practice like?
So, we all arrived there around 7:34 a.m. and Cece brought the best freaking pizza. The air in the room was perfect temperature for eating pizza.
What was the first rehearsal like? And how did you guys bridge the gap between your differing tastes in music?
So, first rehearsal was interesting. Well, Ruby left her parrot in the room, which we thought would be fine. But the winged gremlin actually kept swooping down and stealing everything. Like guitar picks, music sheets, shoelaces, cheese off the pizza. At one point, we called the local vet because we thought it had gone into cardiac arrest. It fell asleep.
And she closes the window. Was that like any indication that I wanted the window closed? Like, yeah, the AC kicks in harder than my dad to make up for the draft. Oh, Ruby Tuesdays starts screaming about the wasp that had flown into the room. And Rootbeer starts waving at it with her drumsticks. Now me, being an intellectual, I knew Rupert should have used her guitar. So I screamed to her, Robbie, use the guitar!
What was your first practice like, and how did you kind of blend your musical styles?
Well, for one thing, during our practice, my idiot hecking neighbors started distracting us with loud yelling, screaming at us until they were red in the face. One of them was on the phone. It was very inspiring.
It sounds kind of like they're yelling at you to quiet down. I think they called the cops and filed a noise complaint.
Nah.
Hi, Mr. Neil Patrick Harris. Know for a fact that Kurt Cobain would be rolling over in his grave right now.
What about cocaine?
No, the war just ended.
So the 1820s?
No, the war.
What war?
You know, the war, World War I.
Why is it called World War I?
I don't know, I didn't name it. Okay, anyway, this girl is trying to find her identity and she realized she has superpowers.
No, she doesn't.
She doesn't? Yes, she does.
No.
How do you not know what this movie is about? You made it.
I did.
Just watch the movie.
Whoa, you can fly? Please don't kick me off your team.
No, it's really cool. We can use that to our advantage in the dance competition.
Let's train!
Wrong era.
Let's see what the judges think.
I hate you. You suck.
Oh, hi. I didn't see you there.
We here at DCATS don't like to use the word hate. It's a very strong word. It really doesn't edify anyone. So next time you're about to say that you hate someone, don't. Unless they really deserve it.
It's time to perform!
Let's perform!
I guess that was okay.
Yay! We won! We won!
I really like you.
I really like you too.
I think we should be friendly mutual companions.
We should start a dance studio on the moon together.
But I don't know how to fly.
I'll teach you.
Kind of temporally challenged at the moment, and I get it, we all have those days. I mean, to be honest, none of us can figure out whether it's the 1950s or the 1930s. There's a hot debate with that, Rob. What do you think, Neil?
Well, Paul, I just don't think that we can go anywhere with this superhero idea. I mean, I can't imagine even making more than one film about it ever. I mean,
yeah,
I just don't think it'll ever catch on.
No, they're just not pop. No one likes superheroes.
Yeah.
No one wants to watch movies about some dude holding a glass thing and saying, Rosebud. Yeah. All right, get out!
Here we have a revolutionary product that will allow us to fix a problem that we have all faced. It is kosher, vegan, and gluten-free. Now listen to this scientist.
Oh yes, this is a very well approved product, and it is quadruped.
Now you know you guys were supposed to create a movie, right?
Roll the clip.
Because I'm with you. I too know the problems of bees. Bees threatened my family for years. I know many people who suffer from bees. They're just a myth. Neil, we talked about this.
It's like Edward Scissorhands, but with salmon.
Now, is this autobiographical?
No, why would you say that? I don't know, it's a stupid idea.
It's not you. It's your hands.
Jen!
People ask me why I'm with you.
They'd say, he always smells like dead fish. But I told myself, that doesn't matter. He cares about me. His personality is what's important. But you know what, Ed? They were right. Your personality doesn't matter.
No, Jennifer, please. I could be better. I could go back to wearing those Ziploc bags on my hands again. Just give me another chance, please.
Ew, no, no, just stop it. Ed, it's over.
My name is Edward Salmon Hands. For as long as I can remember, I've had salmon for hands. Cold, slimy, unlovable salmon hands. I've never married. I grew to despise my horrible, slimy fish hands. They despised me right back. Even my own family turned against me. I'm gross.
Get off me. Your father and I are separating. It's because you're gross. It's your fault. Yeah, that's right. You. I can't even look at you anymore with your gross fish hands. You're just like your father.
Mother, why? I tried to get on disability, but the government rejected my claim. I'm not sure why. Because having fish for hands makes it very hard to hold a steady job.
You're fired, Salmon Hands.
I was bullied in school for years. My locker!
Shut up, fish fingers.
I always dreamed of being a surgeon. People always told me, Brad, you can't be a surgeon, you have fish fans. But you know what? I proved them wrong. I was accepted into Harvard Medical School. I dropped out almost immediately, of course. I mean, come on, I have fish fans. But then, I met someone who really loved me. Disgusting fish hands and all. Don't worry. I'll get you out of here. We're gonna live together. We're gonna get an apartment in the Bronx and have weird orca human babies. I'll flood the complex and we'll swim around in all our fishy glory. Just us and the kids. The messed up, ugly, mutant orca kids. I'm gonna take care of you. Shh, 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 shh. It's okay. It's okay.
You're being removed from the premises.
No! You can't keep us apart! Kirsten, I'll come back for you! Wait for me, Kirsten! I didn't care what anyone thought. We was in love. I swore that if it was the last thing I did, I would set her free.
Salmon Tale, coming summer of 1945.
Salmon!
No. Just no.
Right? There's a president, and he was raised on a sloth farm.
No, get out.
Absolutely not.
You know, I think that idea is actually underappreciated.
There was not a single good idea in there.
No, no, there wasn't. I took up smoking during all those presentations. I'm not a smoker, you see.
But you are smoking.
No, don't hit on me in the workplace. That's not appropriate. Look, we need to figure something out. Maybe, wait a minute. I think I've got it. That Russian might be onto something. We take all the ideas and we collectivize them somehow. We, like these cigarettes, we just put them all together into one thing, you know?
Like an ashtray.
Yes, we make the ashtray of movies.
Yes.
It's perfect. Oh, I have a problem! Oh, I need to quit.
If I had a talking picture of you, I would run it every time I felt blue. I would sit there in the gloom of my lonely little room and applaud each time you whispered, I love you. Screen the moment you came in view. We would talk the whole thing over, we two. I would give 10 shows a day and a midnight matinee if I had a talking picture of you.
old friend. I've come to talk with you again, because a vision softly creeping left its seeds while I was sleeping. And the vision that was planted in my brain still remains within the sound of silence. In restless dreams I walked alone, narrow streets of cobblestone, neath the halo of a street lamp. I turned my collar to the cold and damp, when my eyes were stabbed by the flash of a neon light that split the night.
Well, that was terrible. I didn't know people could vomit that much. Okay, what do we do now, Neil?
I don't know, but Mr. Ruble Kremlin's gonna be awful disappointed with us.
Look, we gotta run. We gotta run away to Kokomo. But before we do that, we gotta hide that video, okay? We gotta bury it in the woods where no one's ever gonna find it, along with that dang keyboard.
With all my hippie idealism once summer comes. I mean, I eat lots of tabbouleh and protest multinational corporations, but it just doesn't fill the hole.
Well, I'm 8 feet tall and my IndieCrack can be seen from space.
That's relevant.
What?
What?
The point is, we have a lot to share. A lot of gifts to share.
And there are kids out there, middle school kids. Maybe, I don't know, students just finishing 6th, 7th, or 8th grade. 8th grade. Gifted and talented students. You know, really gifted, like the top 5%.
And with good conduct, as verified by school counselors, administrators, etc.
Well, of course, silly.
Hey, listen. What's that sound? That intoxicating, mesmerizing sound.
Coming from under the ground.
As if it's been buried.
By studio executives. Just for example.
Does anyone have shovels? Colorful plastic shovels.
I do.
I've hit something solid.
Does anyone have a VCR? It's the mid to late 90s after all.
Yeah, Nirvana.
Pearl Jam.
Ennui and cynicism and flannel.
And so on.
I've got one in my tiny backpack.
Place in the universe.
Croissant, croissant.
Yeah, it's so fun here on Earth.
I love Earth.
We love Earth. We love Earth. We love Earth. Yay!
I hate Earth.
I also hate Earth.
Go attack them.
As you wish.
Get him.
I'll just do it myself.
Dude.
This is it. This is what we need to do.
What we have to do.
And we'll call it rock opera.
And no one will understand why we call it that, and eventually we'll argue about changing the name.
Yes, rock opera it is.
Oh yes, darling. Work it. Yes, give me more. More. Beautiful. Perfect. Oh, yes. Fierce. Give me fierce. Fire in your eyes, darling. Yes. Ooh, work it. Oh. Beautiful. Keep going, darling. I love it. Yes. Give me more. More, more, more. Oh, perfect. Perfect.
Oh. Oh, dear.
Yes. More, darling. I love it. This is so you, darling. Yes. Perfect. Wondrous, wonderful. Yes, darling, yes, I love it. I love it, I love it. Oh, yes, work the keyboard, darling. Work it. Yes, yes, oh, so beautiful. Yes, I love it. Wondrous. Amazing! More heart! I need more heart! Oh, that is so fierce! Yes, yes, yes! Perfect! Beautiful! So glorious! How loving! The camera loves you, sweetie! We all love you! Sweetie. Yes. Work it. So photogenic. More big words. Amazing. This is wonderful.